us about Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law tells us about first the force experienced by two point charges. Second, it tells us about the nature of force, that is, if force is positive, then its nature is repulsive. If the force is negative, then its nature is attractive. So this is your Coulomb's law. So from here, Coulomb's law is applicable for point charges, and it tells us the force between the point charges. Let us consider here, I am considering here two point charges. This is Q1 and here it is Q2, and these positive point charges are separated by a distance small r. Then according to Coulomb's law, the force between them first is directly proportional to the product of charges, that is Q1 and Q2, and second, inversely proportional to the square of distance between them. So here small r is a distance between them, so it is r square. Combining both 1 and 2, we get the force is proportional to the product of charges Q1 Q2 divided by r square. This is your Coulomb's law. Now, if I remove this cost proportionality, I have to introduce a constant, that is force between these two charges is equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by r square. So this is your Coulomb's law. Now here the K is known as constant. Now this value of constant is different in different mediums, or it depends upon the medium. So if it is free space, or we call it as a vacuum, then the value of K is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. If it is some medium, if these charges are placed in some medium, then the value of K is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon. Now let in vacuum is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by r square. So this is your force in vacuum. So and the force in medium is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 divided by r square. So this is all the two forces. Now let us discuss about the permittivity. Now this is a force in vacuum is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 upon r square, and the force in medium in which the charges are placed is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon r square. If you see these two equations, the only difference is in vacuum it is epsilon and in medium it is epsilon. Now let us discuss about epsilon naught and epsilon. Epsilon and epsilon naught. Here epsilon naught is a permittivity of a free space, or we call it as a vacuum. The value of epsilon naught is 8.865 × 10^12 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. And epsilon is a permittivity of a medium in which the charges are placed. So this epsilon naught is the permittivity of a vacuum or a free space, and epsilon is a permittivity of a medium. Now, to know the strength of a permittivity of a medium in comparison to the permittivity of a free space, we calculate or we use the term relative permittivity. Now see what is relative permittivity. Relative permittivity is defined as the ratio of permittivity of a medium with respect to the permittivity of a free space. Means how much times the permittivity of a medium is more as compared to the permittivity of a free space. Now, to discuss it more, let us discuss what is the ratio of the force between the two charges when they are placed in a medium and in vacuum. In first case, these two charges Q1 and Q2 separated by distance r are placed in some medium whose permittivity is epsilon. Then the force is given by Fm is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon r square. In second case, here I place these two charges separated by distance r, same equal charges as I taken in the case of above example, same charges placed at r distance apart and in vacuum, are placed in vacuum. Then the force is given by Coulomb's law between the two charges is in vacuum Fv 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon r square. Now let us take the ratio of these two forces. Now the ratio of the force between the same point charges when at the same distance when they are placed in some medium or in vacuum. So here we have already discussed the force in a medium is given by 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 divided by r square, and this is your force in, this is in medium, and this is force in vacuum, that is 1 upon 4 pi epsilon naught. Here it is epsilon, here it is epsilon naught Q1 Q2 divided by r square. Now if you take the ratio, the force in a vacuum to the force in a medium, that is equal to, we put these values and we get, after cutting we get this much, epsilon divided by epsilon naught. The force in a vacuum to the force in a medium is equal to epsilon divided by epsilon naught. We already know that the permittivity of a medium is always greater than the permittivity in a vacuum, a free space. Then the epsilon r is always greater than we know that permittivity of a medium is greater than the permittivity of a free space. So if you take the ratio, that will be always greater than 1. That is, if you divide more factor with a smaller digit, then this factor will be greater than, always be greater than 1. So here also it is greater than 1 and we get this much. So that is the force in vacuum for two positive charge is always greater than the force in a medium when we calculate the force between the same charges and are at same distance apart.